Well, hey there everybody, it's Red Knight here and welcome back to Heyday. Now I'm very pleased, just before actually starting this video, I actually hit level 32, so that really does make me very happy. So it means what I can now do within this level is I can actually start getting the goats. Now I'm rather pleased about that, especially with the Halloween theme that's currently ongoing at the moment, because I do like those vampire goats. I can also get myself here a new horse, I can start actually making new feed, I can get some additional pens as well, I can make a new product, and I've got some decoration. But I guess we better start looking at the actual game. Now for today's video I'm going to be starting off with some basic farming and administration as usual, and then I'm going to be heading on over to the actual derby, because I've decided to do the derby with my baby farm for this week, and it's going to be a challenge, but I'm actually looking forward to it. So let's head on over to my actual derby now and have a shifty. Okay, well here we are, we're now at my actual neighbourhood, and you can see here that we are in the Champions League, which is absolutely awesome. So the guys have done this completely without my help, which is completely fantastic, and I'm like really, really pleased with their ability to be able to get to this. Now at the moment, okay, we've got 30 people in my hood, and it's awesome. So the level is set at 35, my co-leader here is Perry County, I've got some elders down there as well, I've got a couple of members in there as well, and basically some other co-leaders added to the actual mix, and they are doing a very, very good job. Now not everybody's in the derby, which is actually fine, and those of them that are actually in the derby, I may just make those elders to make it easier for them to actually change the task. So let me go and sort these out. So someone who's in a derby needs to be able to bin, so I'm going to change this one now to elder. Set that one up as an elder. In fact, let's start at the top and see what we've got. So elder, elder, elder in the derby at the moment, not in the derby, elder's in the derby, which is good. Okay, Delano's in the derby, needs to be an elder as well, so let's sort that one out. Now why am I making these people elders? Well, the basic thing is, in the derby, as you know, you need to be able to bin the tasks, and if you are an elder and above, then it's possible. Now for those of you that are not in the actual derby, you can stay as members, that's fine, but any that are in the actual derby itself, they should be elders, at least for that duration that they are in, and that's fine. So let's just confirm with everybody. So hi everyone, just promoted those in the derby so they can bin tasks, and let me tell them what I'm going to be doing. So I'm gonna be here almost every day this week, derby focused. Right, now we're trying to do 275 plus tasks because we are in the champions. Okay, so 275 is good. I like that one. So they've actually lowered the level from 300 down to 275. I can do that one. So I wonder what we can do here. So do I have any tasks that are possible for me to pick on at the moment? But there's a 245, so I could bin that one then, since it falls below the 275. Another 245 there as well, that one can go in the bin. 247 there, that one can disappear. And all of these others there are basically above the 275 mark. So a couple of mine tasks which are very, very good. You've got some help tasks there as well. That one's a little bit less, 271, so that one's got to go as well. Eggs, okay, trucks, and a few other items. Now I can do some of these, but I can't do all of them. So I guess I better like see what I've got in my actual barn at the moment and within my storage to see if I can pick and choose the best task for myself. Well, there is a little blue box, so let's go and have a look at that one. So what does it say? So hi Red Knight, all the Halloween parties will be overflowing with wonderful farm goods. Thank you for everyone's participation, we did it together. Accept this reward as a thank you for your contributions. Well, I got 5 diamonds, which is okay. I didn't actually get a chance to finish all of the 25 with this one, which is a shame. It would have been very, very nice to be able to get some more decorations, but because of time constraints I couldn't. Claim the reward for captaining, so 6 consecutive river boats done in a row, that's good. Next one is 12 river boats. Ooh. Now thankfully, because we had an event, that actually made it much, much easier doing that achievement. So I'm kind of pleased about that. So close that one off. Oh, there's another one there. Sweet. So boat score hunter achieved 400 boat leaderboard points. Yay. Easy, easy peasy. That's taken me up to 28 diamonds. And that's all of the achievements for the moment. So I do like that one. More messages. So let's have a look. Been anything lower than that? Okay, I've done that one. Anyone have cheese? No. Sorry, Red, if you want fruit, I'm selling some. I will have a shifty in a moment. Well, jumping ahead slightly, I've actually chosen a task. So I've collected all of my produce from my machines, I've harvested all of my crops, and I've replanted some of the actual animal products that I'm going to need here. So in this case, corn and wheat. Now, my second field down here at the moment is still a little bit open, so I'm going to be using this one maybe to actually plant some other crops and use that for growing. So that one will be my spare patch at the moment. Now, the task that I actually chose in this case from my derby task is the actual chickens. I felt that all of the other ones that I had there, i.e. the mine tasks, the milk, and the truck, were rather challenging. So if I went for the truck as an example, I could do it, but I don't have all of these items made up yet. So the only thing I would be doing with these, as you can see here, is just binning those items, because I literally cannot make them at the moment. So there's no point in me really actually holding on to them. Let's see if I can work up a few orders that I can actually do. Now, I do like the look of these ones here, especially Frank's Factory, because that will give me vouchers and a lot of XP as well. So I may be able to level up to level 33 very quickly. So 32,000 points. But the one I did choose is the eggs. Now, eggs are relatively easy. I've got quite a few hours to get this one done, so 7 hours to go. Now, I've started off a couple of my actual chicken pens there, but I don't have enough feed to get the last one going. So I'm basically now maxed out my feed mill, and that is going to be producing chicken feed for the next goodness knows how many hours until I've actually got enough chicken feed to feed all of my chickens and keep me going for the 7 hours. Now, I do need feed as such for my other animals, but the priority for those at the moment is very, very low, so I'm not going to worry too much about those. And all I'm doing here now is just collecting the produce from them. And once I've collected the produce, then I will start looking at my actual machines and see what I can make as well. So they're done, they're done, and they're done, and that looks good. Right, now I do have a couple of visitors, and the visitors are after crops, so I could actually serve them, because crops are relatively easy to regrow. It's the actual products that are more challenging. So young lady, here you are, and what does this young lady want? Okay, she wants 11 wheat, so she's going to have to wait a little while for that one, but in fact, I could probably do that now. So here we go, we're growing some more wheat, we've doubled up on my quantities, and then she can be serviced, and that's more money for my kitty, a very, very easy task. 19,000 there, I'm not complaining at that one, and my next field of crops is done as well. But I'm going to hold off actually doing any more at the moment, because I do have plenty in storage. Now I do need some more carrots, of course, so I could probably do those here, and then get those down there. I need some more soybeans for a little bit later, and I can use this single field here now for my actual feed mill products. Right, now we've got a boat over here at the back as well. So what does the boat want, I wonder? Well, it's after the actual indigo, it's after some of the carrot juice as well, bread there. Now, some of that is relatively easy for me to do, so I could probably start loading up the carrot juice, because if I do get a boat task after this one, it would be very, very nice. Now, my carrots are actually growing at the moment, so I'm going to have to hold out on that one, so we're going to have to wait, wait, wait. Hello there, Tom. You need to go back to sleep, young man. So there you go. No, thank you. You're going back to sleep. I'm not going to use you. The actual truck is there waiting for me to spin, so let's do you while we are here as well. So spin that wheel. Where it stops, no one knows. Will it be goodies or will it be a fillet? Yay, a fillet is good. I can use that one. And I wonder, what should I make? Now I do have the actual mailbox here with some envelopes inside. Now there's some gift cards in there as well. Not too many, because I've only helped a couple of people out. But I wonder, we've got 11 at the moment, so that takes me up to 14. So 3 helps there. Now I could do this package here. In fact, I'm going to. Let's go and do a small package here, and let's see what we get. So Alfred should come down the road any second now, and here he comes. So here comes the postman walking down the street, carrying a big parcel with a big smile on his face. What's inside, I wonder? Will it be something glittering? Will it be something gold? Will it be something musical? Will it be something bold? Can I blow things up with it? Can I grow things too? So, Alfred, 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 drop it off and scoodle-dee-doo. So, what is he going to give me? So, young man, thank you very much for the package. I do appreciate that one. And he's left it behind. And we got ourselves some tape there. Oh, my goodness me. Tape. Whoa. That is super awesome. So, I just got myself some free tape there. So, one brand new roll of tape. Oh, wow. Now, how can I use that tape, I wonder? So, can I use it to actually upgrade my barn? Well, my barn is 395 or 400, so we're getting very close to the limit. And I do need tape, I suppose, but not really necessary at the moment. For my silo as well, okay, I need a few more items there as well, but again, not really important. But we're going to check my fishing area in a second and see how I'm doing there. But in the meantime, let's start filling up my actual machines and start working on my mastery as well. So I need some butters and I need some cheese and I need some cream. The goats can unlock at 33, so that's the next level. So we'll do some butters for the moment. I've got 28 more gems there, so I'm going to do another slot down here as well, which is very good. So when I get some more milk later, I can then start maximizing my production on this one as well. Another toolbox, I'll take that one, thank you very much. Right, next machine, ice cream machine. Can't do anything with that at the moment. Okay, we can start making some clothing as well. But what should I do, I wonder? Let me go for the woolly hats. And we go for one sweater and one white sweater too. Lovely. Okay, over here we need some tomatoes, I suppose. Okay, the actual pancake is the better selling item. So I can make two of those within the hour very easily. And I can sell it for a lot more money than I would say sell the hamburger. So at the end of the day, the actual pancake is way more beneficial for me to make at this level because it gives me a lot more money much more quickly. And I prefer that. Now we are going to load up on the bread. Okay, yes, I could actually make some of these other items as well. They're very important. But the bread is just as useful at the moment. Right, sugar, we're good with the sugar, so let's do some white, we'll do some brown, white, white again, and another brown, so mix and match there. Aha, some feed is done, let's go do my chickens. Right, so I now believe all my chickens are fed, and I just need to wait for them to actually start producing the eggs towards my task. In the meantime, let's load my machine back up and keep the production going, because it's very important. Now, I do need some of these other items as well, so I probably could make up a little bit more feed as well. So let's go and do that one. So we replant the wheat down there. And then we go and do a little bit more. So we need some sheep feed as well. We'd do a couple of those and leave that as it is. Now, I can't really upgrade that machine anymore yet. And the same with that one. I need another 5 diamonds, so I could hold off with that one at the moment. Popcorn, I've got plenty of the regular, and a little bit more is not going to help, so let's go and do that as well. I can always sell that. Juicer, I'm waiting on the carrots, which will be ready very, very soon. Where are my carrots? Okay, there they are, down there, 2 minutes and 24 seconds, so that's fine. Right, that machine's done, that one's loaded up as well, the sugar's done, the popcorn pot's done, okay, my cake oven. Right, I need cookies and I need cream, so I can do the cream cakes. Now, 3 hours until they're ready, it's kind of okay. I can get some money out of that later as well. So money's always good. Right, looks like we're going to need more of the actual wheat if I can do any of these tasks. So wheat is going to be a priority, and that's growing 50 odd seconds. Okay, well, there's nothing else I can do here, so let's head on over to my fishing area, shall we? Now, I should have some nets here that will allow me to get some fillets, which is good. That's one lot done, and another one. Now, it's a shame I don't actually get diamonds for these, because they don't fall under the diamond weight, but it's just as good. There's no ghost in the area at the moment, which is a shame, so I actually caught him last night, so I was rather pleased. Let's take all of these fillets, and that's good for my storage, and then I can sell those off or make items as well. So, I wonder, what should I do? Now, because I'm actually doing a task at the moment that allows me to collect eggs, it means I'm going to need a lot more barn space. So I'm going to have to sell off some items, or basically make some items. Now, I think I'm going to be selling off. Selling off will be much, much easier for me at the end of the day. Now, lures. I'm using my lures to actually make the fishing lures from the vouchers. So, next one is in 835 for the mastery. So I've done one, which is good. The mastery on this is a lot faster, so it's much, much easier to do. Shame the worms don't count them. Right, let's just put those nets back into the water as well, because they are done. And then, based with my playing style, I will come back and look at that one a little bit later as well. So that's good. Right, now, as well today, what I'm going to be doing is try to transfer over some of my resources from my daddy farm and maybe upgrade all of these areas over here that I can't actually get to at the moment. I'm tempted to actually open this up and then start chopping everything down in this area, but still keeping these trees at the front here, keeping them across the center barrier, leaving these ones in place, because I do have new items that I can start adding into the game. So as an example, if we go and have a look now within the actual shop, okay, I've got the ability to get some more land, which is wonderful. More land is always good. So we're going to add those land pieces down first of all. So I'm going to go here for that one there, and then another one there, and then another one there. So we are now up to 51, and that is super cool. Let's collect those carrots, and then adjust the direction of my land so it matches. And we missed one. Oh dear. So, turn that, and now my land is all facing in the right direction. Gorgeous, I like that one. Uniformity, very, very important at this stage within the game, I do think. Right, and we can now do a pig feed, which is good as well. So, one machine for my chicken feed, and one machine for the rest of my feeds. And oh no, I ran out of feed. Not good at all. Okay, get that one done, that's good. Right, now what else did I get that's brand new? So if we scroll down here, I can add another cow pasture if I wanted to. Now I've got two already. For me at the moment, because I'm not really maxed out and I don't have the space, so I'm not going to chop down trees, so I don't want to add any more of those in. Now what does please me is I can actually get the goat yard, and that gives me four goats. Now I'm tempted to start adding the goat yard in, but where would I put it? Now it's a relatively small pen, so it doesn't take up a lot of space. You can actually squeeze it into a lot of locations very, very easily. Now I need to think about where I can actually add this one that would look good for my design. Now, should I bring it over here with the rest of the animals and put it over here? Well, at the moment, this area is kind of cramped, and I don't want to be adding another one there, so we'll let that go for the moment. I could have it up at the back of my farm as well. I do like the possibility of having it over here by the dairy. But again, I'm not really keen at the moment on putting something over there. I want to leave that empty. Now, I think my best option is down here. So I'm looking to have it in this location. Now again, I'm not too worried about the trees. I'm going to leave them where they are. But I think just there by my chickens will be very, very good. So we've now got ourselves a goat yard, everybody. So yay, super awesome. Now goat yards need goats. And I guess I better start adding those goats to it. So this one here requires goats, and they're 2,150 coins each. Now I don't actually have any feed, I don't think, but we're going to add the goats anyway because I love the vampire costumes. So I put them all in a nice little group there together. We've got sufficient money to pay for this, which is nice. And there we go. And I open that toolbox, it's locked. So four goats we can have at the moment. And let's go and have a look at my beauties. There they are, just sleeping there. Now we don't have the feed, so I'm going to have to make this feed. So when the actual machine lets me, I can start adding the goat feed into this one. And there we go, our first goat feed, a 38 minute turnaround time. Yay! And very, very soon, my dears, you will have some feed, and then you will be producing happily. And I will be very pleased as well. So that is super cool and awesome. Right, some of my items are ready. Now a little bit more bread there, I think. And we go and collect those carrots as well. And a few more carrots added to the total will be nice. And now we can start making some of these items. Well, we can use the fillets first of all. So I'm going to completely load up on these. Right, now we've got actual 13 diamonds. Now I could upgrade my pie oven, which would be nice. I can't updo my sugar mill yet. I can upgrade my bakery, which is an important one. In fact, that's what I'm going to do at the moment. Or, now I can't do my dairy yet, so I think my bakery is the better option here. So we're going to do the bakery. That's it, my diamonds are back down to one, and we have a new slot. So let's add in some new items. And there we go. My new slot has been used. Super cool. I like it. Right, more feed, and that is good. Right, what's next? So, we can start making the carrots juice as well, which is good, because we've got carrots now. That's three of those loaded up. Those carrots will be ready soon. The chickens will be ready soon as well. 2 minutes, and that's good. 12 minutes there, and 1 minute on that one. Okay, I'm pleased. So, we've got new animals, we've got new farmland, we've got new animal pens, we've leveled up, and we've got our first derby task, and I'm actually really over the moon. Now, I can actually help some of these, so we're going to do Andy with one of the cheeses, and two of the cheeses, good. Okay, Maisie's requesting jewelry, and I have asked that nobody request jewelry. So, Maisie, why do you need the necklaces? Is it to sell or for a task? Now, my rules or my policy is not to actually ask for jewelry, because I think it's very, very unfair to be requesting jewelry if you're going to be selling it. So, if she says it's for a task, then it's good. And I better tell Andy the cheese is dumb, so... actually, no, he sent a message, so what did he say? Thanks, Lucas and Red, for the cheese, I appreciate it. So, you're welcome. Maybe... I'm doing an egg task. Just... looking now, plus recording this for a video. Say hello, and hopefully Andy will come up with a little hello in a minute. Let's see, will he say hello or not, I wonder. Okay, he said hello. I think, because I had a typo then, I said say hell. He mixed it up, but he's done it. So he said go and do the boat, so let's have a look. So the boat is for bread and juices and actual indigo. Now it's a challenging one. Now I could do some of it, which is okay, but it takes a bit of time to actually produce. So I might start requesting. So I'm going to request on the juices. I'm going to request on that one as well. And I'm going to request on one of the juices there. So I can do these ones, I think, and that should be okay for me. And there we go, one of those is done, so thank you. Now that's good, so it means he gets the experience points for those, and Perry as well. So, thanks. Right, those crates have been done, and I thanked both of them for that. And he's also said as well that he is going to have the carrot juice ready in 9 minutes, and that'll be good. Right, Samantha's joined the chat as well, and she actually enjoyed my dab the other day in my last stream, which was really funny. I hope everybody liked it. So, let's say hello as well. So, Andy wants to know, should I stay or go? Now, he's better off staying. I think he'd be more comfortable here. So, I think you should stay. Enjoy the babyhood and support as best as you can. And then, hello, let's just make sure I get it. Samantha. Right. right, okay, so a little message there. So we've got two crates done, as I said. We're making the actual juice for that one. That'll be ready in about 30, like 60, 90 minutes, an hour and a half. That won't be a problem. Animal feed is still producing as well, which is good. Okay, got to make sure I don't run out of all of the feed. So we better get some corn down there as well. That is a key ingredient. Now, he's after some of the indigo, which is not good at the moment. I'm going to say no on that one. She's after the fish fillets, and I'm going to say no as well, because the return's actually not that good. Now, we do need to make more bread. It's a shame I actually did that one before I actually did the boat, so in some ways that's a bit of a problem, because it's going to cause me a bottleneck now. But it's okay, maybe I can find some. And 1 hour's not going to hurt anyway. Right, my eggs are done. So we've got my first batch of 6 eggs, everybody. Yay, we have started the derby, and we are now moving towards completing that final task there. A few more eggs down there. That's taken me up to 12 now, I think. No, it's not, because some of the feed was a little bit later. So we got a little bit of an imbalance there in time-wise. So I'm going to have to be careful of how I actually look at my time for this. Another 6 down here, which is good. And that will be wonderful. Now, what I may do is just not collect those other eggs next time, just to keep that balance a little bit more. So, or then again, we'll just see. So I'm going to be working on here for the next 7 hours or so to actually get this one done. But it won't be 7 hours. I should be able to get it done a lot faster than that, considering that it only takes about 20 minutes to actually collect those eggs. So 117 eggs in 20 minutes for every pen of chickens. Easy peasy, no problems there. Right, okay, so let's do the red dab. That was so funny. I think she liked it. Right, well, let's go and check the paper as well, because you never know, maybe there's something there. Aha! Goat's feed! We'll take that one, that's good. I can use that goat's feed to actually... 3 for 140 will save me a lot of time as well, which is wonderful. I missed out on the second set of goat feed, which is a shame. One bread for 21 coins is a little bit excessive, so I'm going to avoid on that one. Now, we've got a request option as well. I can't do any of these. Yes, I can. So XP there as well, which is good. Can do that one as well, which is nice, and I can't do that one. So that's more XP for my kitty, which is good. Toolbox there, some more tape as well, wonderful. Okay, that pleases me greatly. And what am I doing? Go back, let's try the newspaper again. So, anything else down there that catches my eye to start with? Maybe if I can find some indigo that's very cheap, that would be pleasing as well. So sometimes you'll find 10 for 70 coins, and that's really going to be useful, especially for my task I have at the moment. So if I can find 10 for 70, that would be really, really easy. In fact, I could do that one now, so that one's done. I got sufficient, I think, to not worry. We can now do that crate because I just bought them. And if I don't get any support on those, I'm making. So it's just the bread now that I need to do. So it's a shame I got that bottleneck there with the actual 1 hour, but that won't be a problem. I can come back to that later. Focus on the rest of my actual tasks I need to do. Right, now I did use some of my indigo. How's my big crop going? With 21 tomatoes, 23 indigo, 22. I got lots there, so there's plenty in stock there. Well, let's start growing some anyway. So a few more tomatoes down there. We do more on the indigo as well. We collect those animal feed there, which is good. And we can actually do some of these others now, I think. So what should we choose? We go with the actual pigs for the moment, I think. And then one sheep there as well. Now my goats can be fed because I just bought some, so there you go. Now not all of the goats fed, but you'll see there they're walking away, and one more to do as well. So yay, super cool. I like that one. It looks good, it feels good. I feel happy. Right, now I'm not going to load up that one now. I'm going to leave it for the moment and see how it develops. I think I would just go with the sugar, because sugar is what I'm using with the rest of those crops there. Right, now, I'm getting very close to the end of this video, but let's make some money anyway, so we do that one there. Come back here, so... Yay, says Samantha, on this farm. So dab to the left, and dab to the right, dab to the middle, and do the dab swipe. Yeah, and dab all night. That was so funny. So dab to the left, and dab to the right. Dab to the middle and do the dab swipe. I like that. I like that. I still smile when I think about it myself, so it's good. Right, now I do like the fact that I'm getting these Frank's Factory ones. Okay, silver bars in 8 hours. Let's have a look. Do I have any in production there? Silver bar there in 8 hours. So it's nice to keep it there, but yeah, let me get rid of it till later. Now that one I can't do because it's goat milk. So already my goat milk orders are coming up, but I can't produce any of these for a long time yet. So that one I'm going to bin as well. The only one I've got available that I can do is the pancakes, and that one's good. So more XP as well. So I like it. Another order comes up, and we can harvest those. And I'm going to do it again. Load that one up again, and let's get more chicken feed down. So that is good. Those chicken eggs should be ready over there, so we can collect those. And that's taken me up to 18. So my first set of 18 eggs has been done, everybody. Oh my goodness me. Super, super awesome. Okay, well, that's it for the moment for my baby farm. We've done a little bit. I'm very happy with the way things are progressing today. So I will keep doing this task, and fingers crossed I will get it all done. I need in total to do quite a few derby tasks, because now that we're in the Champions League, it means that I need to do 9 tasks within the 4 days and 20 hours that are left. So that's going to be a challenge considering my ability and level, but I will give it a go. And hopefully with a 275 limit, I can find some tasks that are relatively easy for me. But either way, wish me good luck, everybody, and I will see you in the next video. So have a happy day now, and take care. Goodbye, all.